Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, and I have brought to you some questions of the current affairs that can be useful in your phase one of RBS ABN award. So let's begin with the video, but before that you can download the PDF of this session on the Telegram channel, and the link of the Telegram channel is in description below. So on that note, let's begin with our first question. So who is the chairperson of the Central Vista Oversight Committee? So we have Ashwini Kumar Maurya, Ratan P. Vattal, C.V. Sharada, G.P. Sarkar, Lal Chandama. So these are the five options, out of which option B, Ratan P. Vattal, who is the former finance secretary, is the right answer. So he is the chairperson of this Central Vista Oversight Committee. Now basically this committee will monitor the entire Central Vista project. You should be knowing about this fact that the Central Vista project aims to redevelop the parliament building and the surrounding government buildings. Okay. Now this committee has a total number of 5 members, and it also has a convener, and the convener is the Joint Secretary of Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So these were the facts related to this oversight committee. Next question here is that where is the Aharbal festival celebrated? So before telling you the answer of this question, let me tell you that this is the first time that this festival was celebrated. So now which state or UT celebrated this festival? So we have Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Telangana, Meghalaya and West Bengal in the options, out of which Jammu and Kashmir is the right answer. Now this festival was specifically celebrated by a district of the Jammu Kashmir Union Territory. And which district it is? It is Kulgam district of Jammu Kashmir administration that celebrated this Aharbal festival. Now this festival is basically a festival for attracting more and more tourists to this district Kulgam. And the Aharbal waterfall would be the major attraction, would be the major tourist attraction, and basically this festival is also around this waterfall only. Okay. Next question is, which news agency has won the UNESCO ABU Peace Media Awards 2021 in the Living Well with Super Diversity category? So we have ABP Live, Aaj Tak, NDTV, Doordarshan, The Print in the options, out of which Doordarshan is the right answer. So first of all, let's know about the background of this award, and then we will look at the winners for this year. So UNESCO ABU Peace Media Awards, basically these awards are given in order to promote free and fair media, and this award is given by UNESCO in partnership with Asia Pacific Broadcasting Unit. Now both of these organizations give this award under the Together for Peace initiative, which is nothing but an initiative to promote the media for promoting peace, the free and fair democratic media. Now winners for this year are these. So here we have the categories, winners and the reason. So Living Well with Super Diversity category, in this category Doordarshan has won this award, UNESCO ABU Peace Media Award, for its program, which is named as Definitely Leading the Way program. Now this program is focused on the people with differently abled capabilities. Okay, the people who are differently abled. So this program was based on them. Ethical and sustainable relationship with nature is the second category in which the award was given, and this award has been won by All India Radio for its program called Living on the Edge, the Coastal Lives. Now clearly from the name itself, it is very evident that the purpose of this program was to unravel the lives of the people who live in the coastal region. So clearly it is based on them. Next question is, which state UT has won the Digital Transformation Award in the Digital Health category for its Swasthya Nidhi Survey app? Puducherry, Tamil Nadu, Jammu Kashmir, Telangana, Kerala. So here the right answer is Jammu and Kashmir. first of all, regarding this award, the very first thing that you should be aware of is the organization that gives this award, because this very organization has organized the Digital Transformation Summit as well. And during that summit, these awards were announced. This was the fourth edition of that summit. So which organization it is? It is the Governance Now, which is basically the organization under Sri Adhikari Brothers Group. Now, even if you skip this fact, then it is also okay. But don't skip this fact that Governance Now is the we can say agency that has organized this summit and gives this award. So it was the fourth edition, as I said, of this summit, and the awards were given. Now, Jammu and Kashmir administration has won the Digital Transformation Award in the category of Digital Health for its Swasthya Nidhi Survey application. This application was basically focused on tackling the COVID-19. So basically it was launched to collect the survey related to the COVID-19 disease within the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Next award is given to Himachal Pradesh State Government, and this award has been given specifically for the efforts done by the state government of Himachal Pradesh towards digitalizing its efforts in tackling the non-communicable diseases. Okay, so both of these administrations have been given the Digital Transformation Award. Moving on to the next question, who is the CEO of International Cricket Council? So out of these many options, Geoff Allardyce is the right answer. Basically, Geoff has already served as the interim CEO of ICC, and after 8 months of his tenure, ICC decided to keep him as the permanent CEO. So he has been basically transferred, or we can say promoted, as a permanent CEO of ICC. Now, ICC has its headquarters in Dubai, and do remember, Geoff Allardyce belongs to Australia, and he himself was a player. Next question is, which bank has received approval for acquiring the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperation Bank? So first of all, let me clarify that RBI has released a draft on basically a scheme for the acquisition of this Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank by the Unity Small Finance Bank. So this bank is based in Delhi, and this is going to acquire this Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. But do remember, the acquisition has not taken place. The announcement from either side has also not been made. So it is just the draft scheme that has been released by RBI. Okay. Now, this Unity Small Finance Bank is promoted by the Centrum Financial Services along with Resilient Innovation Private Limited as the joint investor. But here, this organization is important, Centrum Financial Services. Okay, so it is promoting this this Unity Small Finance Bank. Next question is, which bank has launched Move Band Rakho, a secure banking campaign in partnership with Jodhpur Police? HDFC Bank, IDFC First Bank, ICICI Bank, State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank. So out of these many options, HDFC Bank is the right answer. So the basic purpose of this Move Band Rakho campaign is to create awareness about the cyber fraud so that people should be prevented from getting frauded by the people. So guys, here this video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the content that is provided to you. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and if you have really liked the content, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification.